Good morning, Damien. Right, we're here for the 2016 Irish Championship.
Yeah, this is number 41.
Number 41.
Yeah, 41 championships in the, well, obviously 41 years. So it's been going quite a long time, and it's very much an honour and a privilege to be chairperson this year of a very, very hard-working committee. We find ourselves in County Cork this year, very, very bottom of Ireland, the biggest county in Ireland, and where we're going this year is very much, if you want to call it, traditional Irish shooting ground. Like, we'd begin by hunting like in a glen with brambles and fallen trees and brushes and so on, and then we'll move into like big bracken, very big bracken hedgerows with which are basically, they're there in this mountainous region for huge number of years, a great number of years, without any interference from man or machinery. So it's very, very much a natural environment this year we find ourselves in, and it's different. It'll be different from your normal woodlawn type course, but it's something that a lot of our dogs in Ireland would have to hunt in a traditional shooting day.
Brilliant. And there's 35 dogs competing for the championship this
year. Yeah, 35 dogs this year. That was something that our host, Mr. Stuart Greaves, stipulated very strongly. It wasn't particularly the wishes of the committee, but it's something that he wanted, and he obviously knows what he can manage over the 2 days, and we'll adhere by his wishes.
That's really important, isn't it, to have ground?
It's vitally important to have ground, because if you have no ground, you have no pitch to play on. And very simple, you've got to work with the host, the people who are providing you with the ground, with the course that you're going to show your dogs on over the 2 days. So he knows what he can manage. He's very, very good at managing game. And some people will find it strange and different, but it'll be a challenge for handlers on dogs, and something for those who are, if you want to call it, the most proficient to show what they can do and come top of the pile at the end.
And you, one of the ones running today as well.
Yeah, I'm fortunate. I have got two dogs this year again. I had three last year, but I've got two this year. And it's like everything else. I always would say, and I've said this many times in sport, if you look back at the history of sport, any description, I would always say that the top people in sport, or the top teams in sport, they don't need luck. They just don't need bad luck. They don't need luck to win, but they don't need bad luck, because when Lady Luck genuinely turns his back on you, well, you could stop.
Well, good luck for today, anyhow.
Thank you, Janine.
Good morning, Pat and Eddie. You're judging the championship this year. Are you looking forward to a good couple of days?
Yes, morning, Janine. Yeah, it's great to be here. It's an honour to be asked to judge especially our home championship for me. And to be judging with someone as well decorated as Eddie as a handler, it's definitely an honour for me. So yeah, looking forward to a couple of good days, seeing some good dogs, hopefully get a good result at the end of the day.
Are you normally running anyhow?
Yeah, I would prefer to be running, to be honest, but don't have anything to qualify this year, and it's just suited that this was a good year for me to judge, so it was nice to be asked this year.
Yeah, but somebody has to step in and judge sometimes, don't they?
Exactly, yeah, and it's what's our way of giving back as handlers. Somebody has to do it, as you say, so my turn this year.
Good morning, Eddie. So you come all the way from Scotland.
Across the water. Once again, it's a great honour to come across. I've judged the Irish Championship once before, I think it was in Glenarm. We had a great day that day, and I'm looking forward to a great day today, to be honest with you. It's nice to see different type of dog and different type of terrain for what we have at home, but no doubt the quality will be just as good.
The winner of the Springer Spaniel last year is actually running here today as well.
Ah, that's right. Louis qualified there, and I think he qualified on his own right, Pat, I think,
that's right,
across here to run in the Irish Championship. I've judged the dog before, it's a class animal, so I'm looking forward to having the opportunity to look at it again.
Yeah. So you have the winner of last year's Irish and the British here this year, so
yeah.
It's nice to see, you know what I mean? It's probably the first time we've ever had it, I would think. I'm not sure, but I think it probably is.
Yeah, I would think.
Because Louis was second last year, wasn't he?
Was he third?
He was third.
Yeah, that's right. So with a different dog than that won the British. Dog. Yeah. So, right, okay. but both those dogs for Louis are here as well. So.
Good morning, Barry. Defending champion, how are you feeling today?
I'm feeling good today. I've been looking forward to the day. I have to say the bitch has gone well. I won last year, so fingers crossed. Two winning, you never know.
So you've got two dogs running.
Yeah, so my first dog in, a number 20, and then the one I won with last year. And the year before, she got second in a runoff. So I've the top two Irish dogs there the last 2 years, so hopefully I have a good chance.
Good luck for today.
Thanks very much. Appreciate it.
Morning, Willie. What's happened? You normally shoot. You're running a dog this year.
Yes, at last I'm able to get a dog that's good enough to qualify, so I'm enjoying that now. I think maybe I'm sick from the shooting now, so I'll enjoy my dog for once.
Good luck for today.
Thank you very much.
Good morning, Pat. You've got the only cocker running in the championship.
Yeah. Over the moon with him. He's in the championship next week as well in England, so done really well this year with him. Looking forward to this one today.
He says a good year then?
Yeah, good year with him, yeah. Thanks to a friend of mine, Gavin Tagemeyer, who bred him. So, really looking forward to it.
Good luck for today and for next week as well.
Thanks very much. Thank you.
Morning, Dave. So, you qualified for the Irish. Come over to the Irish this year?
Yeah, it's a pleasure, really. Actually, the dog I'm running today is owned by a great friend of mine in Ireland. He managed to, it's actually somebody else qualified with it, so I'm actually a handler really today. Great though, because I like to come to Ireland. You get a crack in Ireland, it's always good fun. So, and the boys, I mean, I love all the boys. They have some cracking dogs, so even just to come to watch some real quality dogs is always a great thing. And I believe we're gonna have some decent weather. It's gonna be sort of 8 degrees and, the only thing we don't know at the present moment is what cover we've got. Nobody knows where we're going and what's going to happen. So we're looking forward to it.
Nice surprise. We know. Good luck you today.
Well, what a problem. Tell me quick. Tell me, please.
Good morning, Pat. It's your first time at the championship. Yes. How was your day yesterday?
Great day yesterday, yeah. The weather was super. The dog went well and made it through today, so I'm happy. All was good. Yeah.
So you got today for your second run today?
Yes, I'm running today. For the first time out, for me it was a big achievement to get to today, so I'm delighted with that. So.
Good morning, Pat. You got the only cocker and you had your first run yesterday.
Yeah,
how did you get on?
He went really well. Very happy with him. Brilliant to be called back. So looking forward to today now. Being there.
What can you remember of your run yesterday?
The heavy cover and his retrieve was just second to none. So I was very happy with that. Brave little dog. So hope he runs well next week in the English one.
Good luck today.
Thanks very
Ivan, you've had your first run yesterday, first time at a championship.
Yeah.
How did you get on?
Very well, thanks. Very well. I was well pleased and the way he went and everything else.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's it.
That's it. Good luck today.
Thank you.
Good morning, Mert. It's morning. The first time you've run in the championship.
Morning, Jan. It is indeed. I didn't actually get my run yesterday, so hopefully I'll have two runs today. Long day yesterday, a bit nervous, but just as bad this morning.
Good luck today, then.
Thanks, William, Jan. Thanks.
Good morning, Earl.
Morning.
This is the first time at the championship, and you're the first dog in today on your first run.
First dog in the day, yep. First time qualifying for the championship, so fingers crossed. Get two good runs today. Long day standing about yesterday, so excited to get in and get started.
But did you see some good dog work yesterday?
Never got up into the line at the last near my run. I seen a few dogs running, but all in all, the gallery was kept back. The viewing wasn't spectacular.
Oh, well, good luck today then.
That's it. Fingers crossed today, we got two runs and see how it works out.
Good morning, Roger. Are you sponsoring the championship for the first time this year and you're going to go out in the field today?
I'm going out into the field, certainly, but actually not the first time. We first sponsored the championships back in the early 90s. In fact, at that time, we also sponsored the retriever championships. My father, who founded the company, had a big interest in the greyhound world. And when I came into the business 38 years ago, my interest was in the gundog world. And so we started sponsoring many more gundog events. And if you like, now my son, Jamie, has come into the business and he likewise has an interest, and it's actually through his endeavours and contact with some of your active committee that we're back on board this year and very glad to be doing so.
Okay. Enjoy today. Are you looking forward to seeing excellent dog work?
I'm very much looking forward to that, yes. I enjoy all sorts of dog work, from hound work, and very much looking forward to seeing good spaniels working. Yeah.
Enjoy today.
Thank you. Thank you.
Places. The winner of the J. McGrath Perpetual Trophy, Perpetual Cup, the Armagh Kilkenny Perpetual Cup to the best Irish dog, goes to number 5 Field Trial Champion.
Well, we have got our new 2016 IKC Any Variety Championship winner with us, Mr. Ed McCauley. Ed and Liz Garvajet. Ed, tell us a wee bit about Liz Garvajet.
He's a 5-year-old dog bred by Paul Carraher, the previous winner of the Irish Championship out of Clonduff Delilah. Bought from Gavin Tegetmeyer at a year old. Look, he's won a lifetime dog, I can honestly say. In all the days I've trained, he's never left me. He's never taken, he's just a brilliant dog.
And he's from a very, very successful line. His mother won two championships.
Two championships, back-to-back championships, Clonduff Delilah under Paul Carraher. Yeah. And he's out of Maisie Ronan Market Trader, UK champion as well. So good breeding and,
good breeding, and he comes from a very good stable and a very good contribution from the handlers and the people who have worked with them and worked with you over the last number of years to bring you and the dog to the position that you're in. Like, we noticed that you did allude to that in your acceptance speech, that you appreciated that input that Gavin had, that Norman had, and that Paul had in basically producing you pups of that standard.
Yeah, absolutely. As everyone here knows, I'm not in trialing that long. Say it's a great group of guys, very welcoming, from the judges all the way to the competitors. As I alluded to, Gavin bought him off. I'm still training with Gavin to this day. We've become very good friends. Mm-hmm. Top guy for spaniels, Robbie Langan, who's taught me everything he knows. That took about 5 minutes, God love him. Mm-hmm. And seriously, Robbie has been brilliant. Pat, Norman, everybody that has reached out to help me has just been phenomenal, and it's great to stand here and recognise the help.
I think that's very important, Ed, and it's good that you can say that. Can I say that the word on the grapevine was yesterday or last night was that Ed McCauley had a good run and other people had good runs, but you were one of the named dogs as having a good run. I heard earlier on then, midday really, that Ed had a second good run, and I thought, well, he could well be there. Whenever you were called to run off, Ed, what did you think?
I thought coming out of yesterday, I thought he had a good run. With the way the ground was, very tough for spaniels. I thought when I got called back, I said, look, you're running against yourself until you get your second run. Hand on heart, when I got today, I don't think myself and Kevin Summers actually had ever seen him go better. It was the one in a lifetime.
In your second run?
Yeah, in, bump, found, was with me, retrieve. Just one of those runs you really want. And when I was called to run off, I automatically assumed that it was going to be for third or fourth or knock the COM out of place. And look, I think on that note, it's great to see myself and the other two new handlers getting first, second and third. It's phenomenal to see that we're challenging for top spots as well.
But I think you have to say it's working with top animals and top company. It's very important to be training and working with top company to bring you to the top table to be able to compete with them. So did you feel in the runoff, Ed, that you were going quite well or...?
You hear videos of guys after runoffs and they say, I knew I had the other dog on the turn. I didn't. I just kept my eye on my own dog. As I said, I knew he never leaves me. He never takes me on. He's just a very honest dog. So I tried to keep him going as much as possible. I knew he was maybe a little bit sticky on the first run. He was a bit out of sorts with so many people around me. But I knew in my heart of hearts he'd gone out and he'd hunted the wind in quite well. And he's a big reiki dog. He likes to get on with it. So, you know, all you can do is, look, I've trusted him for the last 2 years and he's never let me down. So you cast him off and you know he'll give you 110% every time. So that's all he gave me.
Well, you had a very good first run last year in the championship in Ellen Moore, and things came a wee bit unstuck after a very, very good start and an impressive start in the second run. I saw you then in Slane later on towards the end of January, and the dog was very impressive at that time and he was very, very nice to watch. So when would you say your dog has started to come into his full power and full confidence?
I think start of last season, maybe end of November, start of December last season, he really came into his own. I think until then he probably displayed all that particular litter's quality or traits, if you like. He was a little bit sticky, never wanted to do anything wrong, was always a stay the course, but never had that venom. And he picked, we have a little training syndicate that Gavin Tegemeyer has put together, and he picked a couple of runners and he really just turned into himself. From that day until now, every time you cast him off, you think, this is it. He's gonna do something for me, and he gives everything he can every time to find your bird. So.
And doesn't let you down, very important. I know Eddie Scott was very hugely impressed with the dog today, speaking volumes about his power, his style and his presence in general. So you're a very lucky young man to have a dog of that caliber, and you'll make the trip now over to the English Championship and you'll give it a good rattle over there, Ed.
Fingers crossed.
Well done, fella. Thank you.
Thank you. Good luck.